sentiment to inspire the souls of nations of Asian brothers and sisters. Calm sorrow for the absence of our brethren who have gone before us. Earnest solicitude for our own eternal welfare. And a firm faith and reliance upon the goodness, upon the wisdom and goodness of the grand architect of the universe.
Brethren, commending these sentiments to your earnest consideration and invoking your assistance in the solemn ceremony about to take place, I now declare this lodge of sorrow open.
Grand architect of the universe, whose holy sites centuries are but as days, to whose omniscience and ties of the future but as one eternal present, look down upon thy children who will wander amongst the delusion of time, who shall tremble and dread at the dissolution, and shudder at the mysteries of the future. Look down, O God, we beseech thee, from thy glorious and eternal day into the dark night of our era, and presumption, and suffer a ray of divine light to penetrate our hearts, that in them may awaken and bloom the fountain of life, reliant upon the promises and the assurance of a place at thy right hand. Amen.
Those we love passing away into the silent land. Behold, this emblem of mortality, once the abode of a spirit much like our own, beneath these mountain canopies, once shone the bright and busy eyes, within this hollow cavern, once played the ready, swift, and tuneful tongue, now sightless and mute, its eloquence only the lesson teaches us. Think of our brother, who but a few days since was among us in all the pride and power of life. Bring to your mind remembrance of his wisdom, his strength, and his beauty, and then reflect unto this complexion he has come to at last. Think of yourself. Thus you will be when the lamp of your brief existence burns up. Think how soon death for all of us reality. Man's life is like a flower, which blossoms today, tomorrow, faded, cast aside, and trodden underfoot. The most of us, my brethren, are fast approaching, or have already passed the meridian of life. Our sun is setting in the west, and oh, how much more swifter is the passing of our declining years than when we first started upon the journey and believe. As the young are apt to believe, that the rose it hues rising sun of our existence will always to be continued. When we look back upon the happy days of our childhood, when the dawn and intellect first began to exercise its power of thought, it seems but as yesterday, and that by a simple effort of will, we can put aside manner and seek again the loving caresses of a mother. Or could we now realize the idea that our last hour had come, our whole earthly life would seem just as a space in time, yesterday, today. Centuries upon centuries have rolled out behind us. Before us stretches an eternity of life to come, and on the narrow boundary between the past and the present flickers that phony taper return life. When we came into the world, we knew not at what had gone before us, but as we grew into manhood, we learned of the past. We saw flowers bloom as they had bloomed for centuries. We beheld the orb of day and night, pursuing their endless course among the stars as they had pursued them from the birth of light. We learned what man had said and had taught and had done from the beginning of the world to our day. But only through the eyes of faith can we behold what is to come hereafter. And only through a firm reliance upon a divine promise can we satisfy the yearning of an immortal soul. The cradle speaks to us of remembrance, the coffin of hope, of a blessed trust in a never-ending existence beyond the gloomy portal of the tomb. What shall survive us? Not let us hope the petty strifes and bickering, the jealousies and heartburning, small triumphs and mean advantages we have gained, but rather noble thoughts, words of truth, works of mercy and justice that lights up and ennobles every honest mind and remains for good when its body, like this remnant of mortality, is smoldering in its parents' dust. And when God sends his angel to us with his final summons, let us look to it as an act of mercy for many sins and calamities of a long life. And lay down our heads softly and go to sleep without wrangling like forward children. For this at least man gets by death, that is calamities and not immortal. Brethren, to bear grief honorably and temperately, and to die nobly are the duties of every good man and true mason.
Lo, he goeth by me, and I see him not. He passeth also, but I perceive him not. Behold, he taketh away. Who can hinder him? Man that is born of a woman is of a few days, full of trouble. He cometh forth like a flower, and is cut down. He fleeth also in the shadow, and continueth not. Seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are with thee, thou hast anointed his bound that cannot pass. Turn from him that he may rest till shall the day be accomplished as an harrier in his day. For there is hope of the tree if it be cut down, that it will sprout again, and that the tender branch thereof will not cease. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk thereof die in the ground, yea, yet the scent of the earth, and the stalk thereof die in the ground, yet through the scent of the water it will bud and bring forth much fruit like a plant. But man dieth and wasted away, yea, man giveth up the ghost. And where is he? As the waters fail from the sea, and the flood decayed and dried up, so man lieth down and riseth not. Till the heavens be no more, they shall not awaken, nor be raised out of their sleep. My days are past, my purpose are broken off, even the thoughts of my heart, if I wait. The grave is mine house, I have made my bed in the darkness. I have said to corruption, thou art my father, and where is now thy hope? As for my hope, who shall see it? Thou shalt go down to the bowels of the pit, when our rest together is in the dust. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the later day upon the earth. And thou, after my skin worms destroyed his body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom shall I see for myself? And mine eyes shall behold, and not another. For thou hast cast me in a deep, in the midst of the seas and thy floods, and passeth me above. All thy billows and thy waves passes over me. And I said, I am cast out of thy sight. Yet will I look again towards the holy temple. The waters can pass me about. Even the soul of the depth clothes me round about. The reeds and the grass about my head. Are not my days few? Cease. Then let me alone that I may take comfort a little before I go, whence I shall not return, even to the land of darkness and the shadow of death, and the land of darkness as itself, of the shadow of death, without any order, and well with the light in the darkness. our Father who art in heaven, it has pleased thee to take thee from among us, who were our brethren, let me, at this time, as it heals the wounds thus inflicted upon the heart and on the hearts of those who are near and dear to them, not erase the sultry lessons engraven there, but let those lessons always continue distinct, legible, make us and them wiser and better. And that whatever distress or trouble may hereafter come upon us, may we ever be consoled by the reflection of wisdom, and thy love are equal infinite, and that our sorrows are not visitations of wrath, but the results of a great law of harmony by which everything is being conducted to a good and perfect issues in the fullness of thy time. Let the laws of thy burden increase our affliction of those who are yet spared to us, and make us more punctual in the performance of our duties, that friendship, love, and honor demand, when it comes to us also to die, may firm and abiding trust in the mercies dispel the gloom of the dead of this dissolution. Be with us now, sanctify the solemnities of this occasion to our hearts, that we may serve thee in spirit and understanding. And to thy name shall be ascribed the praise forever. Amen. And amen.
So more to be.
So more to be.
For the senior deacon, perform the procession.
Small. memory of our departed brethren. They place these white flowers, emblematical of the pure life in which they have been caught. A reminder that as these children of the hour shall droop and fade away, so too we shall soon see. We shall soon follow those who have gone before us and inciting us to fill this brief span of our existence, that we will live a sweet, savory remembrance.
Sets in the west, to close the door, and herald the approach of night. So one by one we lay us down in the darkness of the tomb, to wait in its calm repose, for the time when the heavens shall pass away as a school, and man, standing in the presence of the infinite, should realize the truth and the visibility of the chair below. Let these flowers be to us a symbol of remembrance of all the good virtues of the brother who has preceded us to the silent land, the token of that fraternal alliance which binds us on earth and which we hope one day will finally unite us in heaven.
Sacrifices alone survive from their fruits in the life of those who strive to emulate them. While therefore nature will love us way, and our tears shall fall upon the grave of our departed brother, let us be reminded by this evergreen symbol of our faith and immortal life, that the dead are but sleeping, and be comforted by reflections that their memories will not be forgotten, that they should still be loved by those of us who shall soon follow them. So trusting in the infinite wisdom and tender mercies of him, without whose knowledge not even a sparrow shall fall, let us prepare to meet them in a place where there is no parting, and with them we shall enjoy eternal rest.
Speak for me.
But some man would say, how are the dead rise up? And what body do they come? Though food, that which sowest into the quicken, except it die. And that which thou sowest not to the body, but that should it be. But bare grain, it may chance of wheat, or some other grain. But God give it a body as it has pleased him, and to every seed his own body. Now this I say, brethren, let flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We should not all sleep, but we should all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trump should sound, and the dead shall be raised up incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory?
But Arthur, it now devolves upon you, you place before us the story of the dead. Tell us of his good deed. Enlarge upon his virtues. Kindle within us a spirit of gratitude and respect, so we may justly mourn for what we have lost and strive to imitate his virtues. Freemasonry does not sit in judgment upon its departed. On the contrary, there is no judge or jury here to expose their secret errors or virtues. We are required to throw around their faults, the broad mantle of Masonic charity, and to suffer the apology of human nature. To plead for those who can no longer plead for themselves. Nevertheless, Brother Arthur, I challenge you. charge you that you are to say nothing about our deceased brother, save what is true. Truth is the divine virtues and the foundation of every virtue. If you cannot truthfully say good things about our brother, let your lips be sealed.
Remembering our brother who was gone from labor to rest, who was passed into the light which is beyond the valley of the shadow of death. The place that knew him shall know him no more, but his virtues are written upon this, his sacred roll of love and memories. Brother Stephen Meadows was entered, passed, and raised in Lodge St. Paul, Lodge, Freeport, Grand Bahama, Bahamas, under the jurisdiction of International Free and Accepted Modern Masons and OES in the year 2002. He remained a faithful member until the 28th day of October 2019 AD, when he admitted and healed into Liberty Lodge number 19, Freeport, Grand Bahama, Bahamas, under the jurisdiction of Free and Accepted Ancient Rite Masons, Prince Hall Origin National Compact in and for the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, where he served as the Tyler until the time of his departure. In November 2020, he was exalted to the degree of the Royal Arch Mason and became a companion in Joshua Holy Royal Arch Chapter number 9. He was a devoted and upright brother, hence he also became a member of Divine Ladies Chapter 3, Order of the Eastern Star in Grand Bahama. His journey in Freemasonry was his own. Brother Stephen Meadows distinguished himself as a true Mason and friend. He toiled in the vineyard of life, assisting everyone, everywhere, as far as his ability permitted, living up to his Masonic obligations. He was a husband, a father, a friend, an advisor, and a companion. But more importantly, he was a worthy brother. Brother Stephen Meadows was a man and a Mason that possesses good morals and great skills, true and trusty, a lover of family, the fermity of life, who discharged his duty with fidelity and honor. 25th day of September 2022 AD, the Grand Architect of the Universe, out of his infinity and tender mercies, saw fit to call our brother from the cares and concerns of the transitory existence, serving a link in his fraternal chain that binds us together. May we who survived him be more strongly cemented in the ties of the union and the friendship. He will surely be missed, gone, but not forgotten. Now, how he died, but how he will, not how he died, but how he will live. May his soul and all those souls of the faithfully departed rest in peace. On behalf of the most worshipful Grand Master, the Honorable Sterling Knowles, 33 degree, the office and members of the most worshipful Serenity Grand Lodge Incorporated, of Free and Accepted Ancient York Rite Masons, Prince Hall Origin Compact, in and for the Commonwealth of the Bahamas and the Caribbean, the Grand Worthy Matron, Sister Crystal Tinker, and the officers and members of the Rules of Sharon Grand Chapter, Order of the Eastern Star, Brother Cruz Alvarez, 32 degree, Worshipful Master, Past Masters, the officers and members of Liberty Lodge, number 19, and Sister Sieska Jones, Worthy Matron and Divine of Divine Ladies, Chapter 3, and the entire Masonic family, we extend to the family, especially his wife, Allison, and sons, Chris, Cameron, and Courtney, friends and comrades, our deepest sympathy and sincere condolences.
continue on. Our recollection of our departed brother has been refreshed. We must now ask ourselves, was he a good and true mason, a worthy man, an unwary toilet in the vineyard, and in possess of so many virtues as to overcome his faults and shortcomings? Answer these questions as the mason should.
Man judgeth not of man. He whose infinite and tender mercies passeth all comprehension, whose goodness endureth forever, has called our brother hence. Let him judge. In ancient Egypt, no one could gain admittance into the sacred asylum of the tomb until he had passed under the most solemn judgment before a grave tribunal. Princes and peasants came there to be judged, escorted only by their virtues and their vices. A public accuser recounted the history of their lives and threw the penetrating light of truth in all their actions. But if it were a judge that the dead man had led an evil life, his memory was condemned in the presence of the nation and his body denied the honors of the body. But Freemasonry has no such tribunal to sit in judgment upon a dead. With her, all the good that her sons have done lives on after them, and their evil interred in their bones. She does, however, require that whatever is said concerning them shall be the truth. And should it be ever said that of a mason nothing good can truthfully be said, she shall mournfully and pityingly bury him out of her sight in silence.
Brethren, let us admonish by the words we have heard. Lay to the truth to what we have listened, and resolve so to walk that when we lay us down, it will be the purpose of our brethren to strew white flowers at our grave. Keep our memories a sweet remembrance. Brother Senior Warden, announce to the brethren that our labors are concluded, and it is my pleasure that this lodge of sorrow be closed.
Brother Junior Warden, it is the orders of the worshipful master. The labors being ended, it is his orders that it now be closed.
Brothers, communicated through the worshipful master to the senior warden, to me, the labors of this lodge of sorrow is now closed.
Let us make the chapter.
Most eternal wise God, as we depart this place, but not from your presence, we pray for safe journey mercies, O God. We pray for this family again, that you may bind them with cords that cannot be broken. Touch them in areas that only you can fix, O God. Only you can console. Only you can fix. We thank you, O God, and we bless you as we leave this place. We reflect on what was said and what was done here, O God, and that we pray that it may draw us closer to you. We bless you, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we ask and pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
So would it be.
So would it be.
So would it be.
So would it be.
So would it be.